everyone. Welcome back to my page, notjusthere.info. Okay, picking up where we left off, we're going to now do bag 9, which is the infamous state board test. So she's still gooey and stuff, which in real time, she's going to be gooey because you just finished with the application of the bleach and the chemical relaxers. So keep that in mind, which is why I said be sparingly on the gel, you know what I'm saying? We are going to be doing 4 rollers up here. 6 rods on cold rods on the left side. Pin curls on the right side. And your finger waves in the back. And at the bottom of your finger waves, more pin curls. And that's your state board set. You have, I believe, 35 minutes allotted for everything. So, let's get started. Which side you do first, whether you do the rods first or whether you do pin curls first. I don't know if they tell you. I don't think so. I think you're on your own. It doesn't matter. So I believe I started with the rods. Again, even with the sectioning up here, you don't want it to be. You want the sections to be about the size of the rod that you're using. Now, also, like most of us, once you start working, you're very used to taking one paper and folding it in half on the ends. On the test, you cannot. Holding your comb, because you can't put that down either. First paper on top, and then your paper on the bottom. And usually what helps me is I'll take in, once I get them in my hand, I'll hit it with a little water so the papers stick to the ends better. And then slide it to the bottom, just like so. Her ends are in paper now. Now I can put in her rod. This is something you guys definitely, if you're not used to rolling hair, you have to practice this. I hope y'all can't hear my loud neighbors. Probably can't. Okay, so here's your rods. 6. If you could get them in that neat, you'll pass. That's not the neatest in the world, but if you get them in that neat, you're good. They're looking for them to be as neat and your parts as nice as possible. After you are done putting your rods in, that's when you take your cotton and you lace all the way. I go in and out the rods. You don't have to actually use fluid, but you're going to mimic using the curl activator. On the perm solution. So I didn't even take the cap off, even though I had some in there. Water. I think I had water in here. I don't even know. But anyway, you just mimic doing that. you know, make sure that they see what you're doing. They'll tell you when to go. Okay, you can start on the other side. So the pin curls, four in the back, clockwise. The front row will be counterclockwise. Okay guys, those are really like not the best pin curls, kind of tacky, but you get the concept. Clockwise, pins going that way, counterclockwise, pins going that way. That's what matters, what they're looking at on that note. Okay, last but not least, finger waves. This is a standard cone. This is about the size that you need for your finger waves. As you can see, it's not as big. And this white comb might be a slightly bigger than the one that I got with my kit. This comb. But this is a hair cutting comb. As you guys know, you cannot use this for the finger waves. And this is your rat tail comb, which it has to be plastic. So I just basically wanted to show you all the different combs that you guys will be using. It really pays to have at least two of every comb, because just in case a comb hits the floor, you can't use it again. So it always pays to have a backup. And also in video 4 of the bag packing, I show you the actual comb that I got when I first got my kit from school. That's the comb, which I think is a little bit smaller than this one. But that's the comb you're supposed to use for your finger waves. All right, moving on. All right, so guys, you know, you have to start with your C-shaping. Make sure that your finger wave starts like two fingers down from up here. And two fingers in between each row of them. Guys, state board set. If you can get them in, at least that, better than that. But if you can do that, you can pass, pretty much. I think my other video, they might have been a little bit nicer, but basically same concept. I'm not great at them. And also too, from earlier from your rods, after you finish demonstrating with your cotton, you can't take it down and move it out your way, so it's not in your way when you try to do your finger waves. They just need to see that you did the procedure, and when they nod their head and let you know that they acknowledge you've done it, then you can remove it before you start your finger waves. So guys, that's the state board test. If you have any comments or questions, please put them in the comment box below. Subscribe. I hope that was helpful, guys. I hope that my videos have been informative. Some of you guys have been letting me know that they have been, and thank you for that. I'd like to thank you for that. And all the support you guys have been giving my videos. I'm sorry for my slowness, but unfortunately, other things in life has just kind of slowed me down because I'm not getting paid for this, to live off of this. So this is just something I wanted to do. I'm also going to put up another video on how to do a proper haircut. You guys need to watch that, because I noticed when I watched the first one, I left the one procedure out, and it was the layer cut. And so I'm going to show you that in the whole haircut, because you're going to have to know how to do that whole haircut anyway. So, again, thanks for watching. Till next time.